Hi, my name is Bjorn Lo, and I'm co-founder of Edible Garden City. We are a social enterprise based in the urban farming industry in Singapore. Chefs like Jamie Oliver that did a lot of programs exposing the perils of the food system and cheap food. And there were a lot of articles on going back into the country and being self-sustainable, building farms and growing your own food. And that really kind of caught on. It was a whole series of milking the cow every morning, being dirty all day, you know, filled with cow manure. We grew our own food, we made our own beers and wines, and it was a life that was quite simple, hard at times, but simple. But once I did the whole stint, I was like, no way I was going to go back into the office or corporate setting. I wanted to pursue this full time because I saw a different way of living, a different way of doing things. Actually, it's quite hard to start a farm in Singapore. You need to have an established company. You need to go and tender for land. It's so difficult. I've spent all our savings on that few years that we were doing the explorations. Of course, then there were feedback saying that, you know, you have gone to school, you've done your masters. Why are you then going back into an industry that is may not fit your qualification? But I think all of that for us were noise. Oh, I never intended to build gardens. I wanted to grow food for people, to be a farmer. But that was what the opportunity was. Over the last 8 years, we have built about 200 plus edible gardens all around Singapore, from people's homes to hotels to shopping malls. 4 to 5 years ago, we started our own urban farm in the middle of Queenstown in Jalan Penjara, where we were testing a urban farming model that created social, community and environmental impact.
I was on social media and I came across EGC. I was kind of wowed by what they were doing. And I told myself that, I really want to be part of this EGC mission to reach out to our fellow Singaporeans, to lead them, to encourage them to how to grow their own food.
Somewhere around 2.5 years ago, I came across Bjorn himself. He showed me the place and, you know, I saw it and I was like, I want to do this, because when I was young, I did a lot of growing in my own corridor.
The spirit of this place and the people is something that's really amazing. Everyone is so helpful, so warm, so welcoming. They have this common passion and purpose to help each other, to work with nature. It's just a great place to be.
We've done a series of studies on how horticulture therapy can actually help people with mental illness and mental challenges to actually improve their mental well-being. So for us, that was very important, because then that will redefine that urban farms is not only a place to produce food for the community, but one to produce mental wellness service for the community as well. So how do we recalibrate urban farms into urban care farms is where we are working towards. Everyone has their own little journey with plants and with nature. Today, everything may look very lush and green and beautiful, but tomorrow, everything might just collapse and die. but also teaches you certain life lessons that, you know, sometimes there are failures and sometimes things are very impermanent, keeps changing. It's a therapeutic journey.